What's up, everybody? This is Blockus, and today I'll be showing you how to build an awesome mechanical arm item sorter using Create 0.3 for Minecraft. And if you don't know what that is, it's a really awesome mod that you should check out, and I have a link for it in the description. So before we get started, I'm going to go ahead and show you how this thing works in general. This conveyor belt right here is going to be transferring our items across. We have the intake mechanism right here, which is going to pick items out of the basin and place them right here on the first block. And then you have items flowing down the path, getting detected by the content observers, which are going to send a signal to the clutch at the beginning of the circuit, telling it to stop whenever they detect the appropriate item. And then they're going to send a signal down there through the redstone torch, telling the mechanical arm to start running and pick up the item off of that spot. And once the item is picked up, the observer block or the content observer is going to stop detecting anything, and then the conveyor belt is going to start moving again. So why don't we go ahead and throw a few blocks on here and see how this thing works. As you see, the yellow blocks are going, and then the conveyor belt stops and they start getting picked up. And then you'll see the blue blocks also doing the same thing. And then the system eventually stops in the very end. You see, everything got picked up and the conveyor belt just keeps going. Now, as you see, the system cannot be flooded. If we toss a ton of them on there, it's just going to be stopped. And that issue is going to be apparent as we start building the system. You'll see that if we don't set it up with this mechanism that stops it, you are actually going to have a lot of overflow and a lot of missed items. But if there's one thing that we can agree on right now is that this thing is pretty cool and you probably want one. So why don't we go ahead and get started on building it? Alright, so let's go ahead and grab some items to get started, and we're going to start by any normal building block. We're going to get some chutes, some chests, some shafts, some belts, and a basin. And don't worry, I'm going to explain what each one of these components is doing as I'm placing it. Oh, and we're also going to need a funnel. Let's not forget that. This is going to be for our trash collection. So let's go ahead and place two blocks right above each other, and then we're going to go sideways for a total of 11 blocks. And this is going to allow us to sort for 5 items. So if you want any more items, you're going to need to add 2 blocks per item, and it's going to be very easily expandable. Next, we're going to skip the first block, and we're going to place a chute behind every other block. And then we're going to place a chest under each one of these chutes. And remember that these chutes right here are functioning exactly like a hopper, except much faster. Next, we're going to go 2 blocks from the back and 1 block above, and then we're going to draw this line of blocks as well all the way to the end, 11 blocks in total. Next, we're going to place a shaft on both ends. There's going to be one shaft here and one shaft on the other end, and then we're going to get our belt and we're going to right click the first one and then right click the second one, and that's going to place our conveyor belt. So now we're going to start placing our intake mechanism. We're going to place this basin right here on the very edge, and then we're going to place a chute above it and a chute going out the side of it. And then we're going to place a chest facing the front of the contraption. So this is where we're going to be putting in items that need to get sorted. And then we're just going to place a block right here that's going to be the future home of a mechanical arm that's going to work on the intake mechanism. And with that, I think the only thing that's left in this part is the trash mechanism. So we're going to go ahead and place a funnel at the very end. Just like this, we're going to have to be looking in that direction. And then we're going to place a chest right behind it. And this also, in this setup, operates kind of like a hopper that's facing sideways. It's going to grab everything off of the conveyor belt and place it into the chest. So now that this part is done, I think it's time to start putting in some motors and getting some moving parts going. So first of all, we're going to get rid of all the items that we don't need anymore, which I believe are going to be everything here except for the building block. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we don't need this. We don't need the chute. Yeah, we definitely don't need any of these items. So we're going to keep the block, and then we're going to grab a motor, a gearbox, and a clutch. And just to give you a quick overview, the motor provides rotation, the gearbox allows you to change the direction of the rotation, and the clutch allows you to turn the rotation on and off. At least in this setup, I don't know everything about the mod, but this is how I'm using each one of these components. So first of all, we're going to place the gearbox right here on the edge of the conveyor belt to turn the rotation sideways. Then we're going to place a clutch And then we're going to place a motor, and we're going to point at the number here and use our mouse scroll bar and go all the way up to 64. This is the speed that I've tested it at, but you can definitely experiment with these numbers. And we're eventually going to power this clutch in order to stop the conveyor belt whenever we need to stop it. So it definitely needs to be in this orientation. And I think with that, we're done with the intake and the trash mechanism, and we can start putting some mechanical arms and getting this thing working. So let's just grab some mechanical arms and some small cog wheels, and we're going to go ahead and start setting some of these up. So the way this thing is activated is first we're going to right-click the source, which is going to be this basin that we placed earlier, and then we're going to right-click the first block on the conveyor belt twice, and then we're going to place the mechanical arm, telling it to pick items from the basin and place them on that first block on the conveyor belt. So I'm going to place a concrete block right there, but it's not going to get picked up until we power up the mechanical arm. And for that, we're going to need a cogwheel, the small cogwheel that we brought with us, and a motor. So I'm going to go ahead and place the cogwheel here, and then I'm going to go up and place the motor looking down, and then we're going to configure the motor to spin at the fastest speed of 256, which is the full speed of this motor. And once that done, this, as you see, the mechanical arm went ahead and picked up the concrete block, placed it down there, and it went into the trash. So everything is ready, and we're just going to need to put in our sorting mechanism. So we're going to do the same thing for these arms. We're going to single click the spot in front of the chute on the conveyor belt, and then we're going to double click the chute, all with our right mouse button, and then we're going to place the mechanical arm right there. So right-click, and then right-click twice, and then place it. And so each one of these arms now knows to pick up items that pass in front of it, and is going to do that regardless of the situation now, but eventually we're going to program it to only pick the necessary items. So let's go ahead and place cogwheels right next to each one of these mechanical arms so that we can power them. And remember that the rest of the mechanism is going to be at the bottom, so we're going to have to clear some space down there. But let me first put these cogwheels in place, and the conveyor belt is getting stuck. Let me just go up. This is getting a little annoying. Let me place them from a little far away. It's not that hard. I'm just new at this. So now that these are placed, we're just going to go under the whole thing, and we're going to dig two blocks down. And this is not to place anything. We're just going to use this to walk around and place our clutches and motors, which we have on us. So we're pretty much almost done with this. We're just going to look up now, and we're going to place a clutch on each one of these cogwheels, and this is going to allow us to turn this mechanical arm on and off. So we're going to place 5 clutches, and then we're going to crouch and place motors, and then we're going to set each one of these motors to 256, which again is the fastest, because since we're stopping the conveyor belt, we don't need this mechanical arm to wait for anything, because everything is working in a smart way. So now that we placed the last motor, let's go ahead and fill up this space with, I guess I'm just going to use sandstone to keep everything looking nice. And we're going to go back up there and finish the rest of the circuit. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab some redstone dust, some redstone torches, and a content observer, absolutely, because these are going to be used to detect the blocks that are going on the conveyor belt. So let's go ahead and put some of the stuff we don't need back, and we're going to go ahead and get started. And this part is going to be pretty simple. We're actually going to be working with good old redstone, which I'm pretty sure you've been missing by now in this tutorial. So let's go ahead and place these content observers against the conveyor belt facing outward, facing directly towards the mechanical arms. And now we're going to go ahead and go 2 blocks under them, and we're going to draw a line all the way across to the end. Next, we're going to place a block of redstone exactly under each one of these and break the block next to it. So we're going to want them to alternate just like this. And next, we're going to start breaking the blocks right in front of the redstone blocks. And this is going to allow us to get access into the other side. And so the last thing that we need to do here is we're going to place some redstone torches on the other side of each one of these redstone dust blocks. And what this is going to do is they're going to activate the clutches all the time, which means that the mechanical arms are going to be off by default. As you see, they're turning off as we place this. And whenever the detector or the content observer detects something, it's going to send a signal down and is going to start the mechanical arm. So there's one step left here that's going to allow the system to recognize blocks. So we're going to pick five different kinds of blocks to detect. And I'm going to go with different colors of concrete because that's the easiest to see. So let's get those and put them in our inventory. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and right click that tiny little spot. Well, not like this. We're going to click that tiny little spot to mark, tell this content observer to only detect this block. So if you throw a different kind of block, it's not going to say anything. So really, this block is doing most of the work for this system, and everything else is just for show. So from here, if we throw something, as you see, the last arm should reach for it and pick it up. But the only reason we're going to need to build some more parts here is, as you see here, and I mentioned this earlier, is if you overflood the system, you'll see that the arm doesn't have enough time to pick stuff up. So what we're going to need to do is tell the system to stop the conveyor belt whenever we have the right block in sight. And that's going to bring us back to the clutch that we placed very early on in this tutorial. So let's go ahead and place a line of blocks coming out of the content observer and looping all the way behind into the clutch at the very end. And then we're going to place one block coming out of this line and leading into each one of the content observers, because we're going to connect all of these to the clutch. And it looks like I forgot to bring repeaters, which we're going to need now. So let's go ahead and get some repeaters. I'm pretty sure they are in this chest. Yes, we have repeaters here, so I'm going to grab the repeaters, and no, we're going to need the blue concrete. So let's go ahead and finish the circuit. What we're going to do here is we're going to place a repeater coming out of each one of these content observers. Remember, it's pointing to the back, and then we're going to put a repeater pointing the other way, going into the clutch to the end. This is pretty simple. What it's going to do is whenever one of these content observers is sending a signal, the conveyor belt is going to be stopped. It's as simple as that. And it's the last part that we need for this circuit. So the entire item sorter is completed, and we're now ready to place items on the left and have them sorted all the way to the right. So why don't I toss just a piece of yellow concrete there? And as you see, the conveyor belt stops and the arm picks it up, which is all perfect. So I'm thinking that this is actually done, so why don't I go ahead and place all of these concrete blocks in the chest, so we'll see how it actually works appropriately. And I'm actually just going to go ahead and throw everything in there, because it's supposed to process trash as well. Now while you're going to watch it, I don't think I'm going to need to provide commentary the whole way, because it's just enjoyable to watch, so I'm just going to quickly remind you that my channel is really new, and instead of asking you to consider subscribing, I'd like to ask you to give me any feedback that you can. If you watch this tutorial and you think it's horrible, please take a moment to tell me that. And if you think it's cool and that you learned something from it, and maybe that you want other tutorials that are similar or different, please let me know. That would really mean a lot to me. Other than that, it looks like we are starting to place the trash on the conveyor belt and nothing is getting picked up, so we know that everything is working correctly. So I think that this has actually been a success. Honestly, I have not played survival with this mod yet, so I don't know how expensive this thing is. I have a feeling that these motors that I'm using might be pretty expensive, but let me know if you know anything about that. And once I start playing the game with this mod in survival, I'm pretty sure I'll have a better sense about what everything costs, and I'll start to talk about that in my tutorials. But for now, I want to say that I really appreciate you watching all the way to the end. Thank you so much for coming by here, and I will see you next time.